Hi, this is Tim Jones. Welcome to this edition of View from the Bleachers. You know, when our two daughters were finally grown up, my wife and I decided, somewhat impulsively, to sell our suburban house and let's move. We moved to a quirky but lovely island, 75 miles from the world we had known for a quarter of a century. So we now live in an idyllic setting on an island called Kameno Island, overlooking Puget Sound, and snow-capped mountains. Ah, it is the island life. Kameno Island has a well-earned reputation as sort of a haven for artists, which is one of the reasons my artist wife was drawn here. In our brief time in this new community, we've met dozens of people, but the one constant among all of them is they are exceptional people, which I have to say is starting to get on my nerves. Seriously, it's really starting to annoy me. I'll tell you more on the other side. Welcome back to View from the Bleachers. I'm still Tim Jones. Like I was saying, my wife and I moved to a lovely island not long ago, and well, it's been hell ever since. And that's because apparently, in order to live on this island, you must be the next Picasso, or Santana, or Hemingway. And you must swear an oath to spend at least 30% of your time volunteering to protect the rainforest or bottle feed orphan kittens. Don't ask me how I managed to sneak past the island security. Some border guard must have called in sick the day that I arrived. I'm not kidding. Everybody on this island seems gifted in some way. If you haven't published a book of sonnets or play the lute, well, you're viewed as, well, a bit of a disappointment. Last week, I met a novelist, a painter, a sculptor, and a quilter, and that was just in the checkout line at my grocery store. By contrast, my biggest artistic achievement was playing Frère Jacques on the recorder in my sixth grade orchestra. Not to brag, but I totally crushed it. Would you like to hear me play it? Never mind. On second thought, I really wasn't very good at it. Well, in addition to being artistically gifted, everybody I've met so far is also great with their hands. If I compliment someone on their stone fireplace, undoubtedly they designed and built it themselves using rock that they gathered from some undiscovered river in Montana. If I meet someone who flies their own plane, oh, you can bet that their plane is a replica of a 1943 Piper Cub, which they built by themselves watching YouTube instructional videos. And don't bother asking someone to play golf here on a Thursday because, oh, Thursday is community barn-raising day. If you're a musician, which on this island means you play at least four musical instruments, it's a given that you handcrafted your own violin. Oh, and something that you can be seen playing every Thursday during breaks between community barn raisings. It is extremely intimidating to be around all these culturally high achievers. Turns out that nobody here is trying to keep up with the Joneses. They passed this Jones a long time ago. But what's most galling of all about all these islanders is that despite all their talents, they're annoyingly nice. Everyone on this island is friendly. They would gladly offer a stranger a cold one, no doubt from their own stock of homemade micro-brewed beer. Worse yet, everybody here volunteers. Everybody. They will never brag about all the things they do for others because, well, that would be boastful. But trust me, if they're not busy building a deck from driftwood that they gathered from the beach, they're building a new animal shelter. Unless, of course, it's Thursday, because on Thursdays they're busy, you guessed it, raising barns. Well, I quickly realized that I was going to seriously need to step up my game before they kick me off this fantasy island. So I'm committed to making the following changes to show these people that I can keep up with them. From now on, I'm going to cut way back on my TV viewing so that I can spend more time mentoring troubled youths. Just as soon as football season is over. I can't let down my Seattle Seahawks. Second, I am going to learn to play a musical instrument. I'm thinking I might start off with a triangle and work my way up to cymbals. I'm also going to offer to build a garage for some needy family. Let me be very clear. I don't know the first thing about how to build a garage. I'm just hoping to find some needy family that will refuse my generous offer because they have absolutely no need for a garage. thereby allowing me to nevertheless tell others about my magnanimous gesture of help. Oh, who am I kidding? I don't have the talent, let alone the attention span, to do any of this stuff. For me, it's a major artistic achievement if I can just remember the lyrics to a Beatles song. There's simply no way I'm going to be able to keep up with all these annoyingly exceptional people. So that's why I've decided I'm going to put our house up for sale. I've told my wife we need to move to another less stressful community, one where I'm not always feeling so inadequate, a place I'd feel more at home. So does anyone out there know the way to the island of mediocrity? Could you text it to me? Well, that's the view from the bleachers. I'm Tim Jones. And remember, if you like this video or simply feel sorry for me, please click on the subscribe button below and share this post with your friends or anyone you'd like to annoy. For more of my humor, just visit my website, viewfromthebleachers.net. Well, thanks for joining me. That's it for now. Bye now.